when I was born, my mom looked at the doctor and said, "Oh my God, she has a toe for her thumb." Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I am going to film for you today a get ready with me for date night with my husband, but not just your average get ready with me. I'm gonna film for you a get to know me, get ready with me. So I found a whole list of questions that I'm gonna read out and answer for you guys so that you can learn a little bit more about me and who I am. So let's answer some questions. We're gonna do our hair first. So this is the Domaness Invisible No Gas Spray. I love this stuff. I just section off my hair into, I like to do this bottom section first, and then I'll do the middle section and the top section. So I start at the top of my hair, and then I kind of curl my way down. Okay, so first question, where did you grow up? I grew up in the east portion of the Bay Area. And so I live like an hour from San Francisco. So that brings us to question number two, which is, where do you currently live? I currently live in the San Francisco Bay Area, and I live in like a suburb town, and I love it. It's cost an exorbitant amount of money to live here, and Kyle and I will need to pay a lot of money to buy a house here, but I think it's gonna be worth it. So, question number three, who is your best friend? I have a lot of close girlfriends, but my best friend is my husband. How tall are you? How short are you, should be the question. I am 5'2", 5'3" on a real good day. Dogs or cats? Okay, when I was a kid, I grew up with cats and dogs, but if you had asked me my preference when I was a kid, I would have said dogs. And then when Kyle and I wanted to get an animal together, we looked at our schedules, because Kyle works 12-hour shifts and so do I, and we both thought, like, we can't have a dog, there's no way. We thought, okay, well, like, maybe let's get a cat. So we looked at the cats, and that day was the day that we wound up with Bella. And Bella, if anybody knows us, Bella is the love of our life. I don't know, I guess that was the really long way to answer. Dogs or cats, I think both. Okay, what year were you born? I was born in 1991. December 3rd is my birthday, so that makes me 27. And are you in or have you gone to college? I have gone to college. I went to a lot of college. I like knew from, I don't know, like 10 years old that I wanted to be a nurse. So when I graduated from high school, I went straight into community college. It was way more financially affordable because I knew that I wanted to be a nurse, and nursing school is really expensive, y'all. And so I knew that I was gonna be so much in debt from that, that I didn't wanna be providing myself with unnecessary debt when we have a perfectly wonderful community college where I live, and I got a great education there for like next to nothing. I came out of community college with zero loans. Next question, what is your favorite drink? Easy answer, wine. What is your spirit animal and why? My two favorite like zoo animals are a giraffe and an elephant. And that is because I think they're the most like awkward of the zoo animals, because, you know, giraffes are super tall and elephants are super wide, you know? And I feel myself that I can be kind of an awkward person. We all can. If you feel awkward, you're not alone. And so I feel like I can relate to their sense of awkwardness, but they're beautiful and incredible creatures. And I like to think that maybe I'm the same. So there's that. Okay, number 11, you are wearing perfume, what scent is it? I will say that like one of my like all-time favorite perfumes is the Victor and Rolf Flower Bomb, but I also like the Brit by Burberry. That one is so great too. That's actually like my current obsession. Tea or coffee? I like tea, I love coffee. Okay, number 13, what are your life goals? Well, I think I accomplished one of them already, becoming a nurse. That was one of my life goals. I got married to a really great guy. I accomplished that life goal. I guess the one like big one left for me is I wanna be a mom. I'm not like a professional makeup person by any means, but I just do the makeup that I know how to do. So that's what we're doing today. Number 14, What sports do you play or have you played? Funny story. Okay, so I grew up dancing my entire life, which I think is a sport. Come at me if you think I'm wrong. One year decided I'm gonna play basketball. I'm gonna play community basketball with my friends and it's gonna be so great. I was really excited. I actually I wasn't awful. Honestly, for somebody who danced their whole life, I was really not bad. I was not a rising Steph Curry star, but I was fine. And then the first game hits, right? Okay, so we're playing our first game and we were playing they were very aggressive. I played forward and I went up to grab a rebound and collided with one of the girls. Well, I think she pushed me, but we can argue that later. And I twisted when I fell and tore my ACL. I knew as soon as I was headed down to the ground that something was wrong. But I was maybe I just pulled something. Nope, tore my ACL, completely tore it. So I had to have knee surgery. So long story short, the only time I tried to play a real sport, dance is a sport, don't get it twisted. The only time I tried to do something different, I tore my ACL. So that was the end of my basketball career. Number 15, have any books you've read changed your life? If you haven't read The Art of Racing in the Rain, read it, but also be prepared to cry. I mean, it's a phenomenal book. Again, if you have not read it, read it. It's so good. Also, I should say, I am not a professional makeup doer, so if I do things wrong, you can judge me, but don't come at me for it, okay? Number 16, what is your favorite movie? This is maybe an unpopular opinion, but The Shawshank Redemption, I think, is so good. It's what I would say is my favorite movie. The next question, number 17, who are your favorite YouTubers? It will come as no surprise that I love Remy and Alicia Marie, big fans. Big fans, big fan. I'm only one person, what? I also love family YouTubers. I used to really love this one channel called Raising the Bars, and they were her name was Allison, and she had a channel with all of her kids, and I think she went through some rough times with, she had a near-death experience in her most recent pregnancy, and she doesn't post very often since that happened, which makes me sad because they used to daily vlog, and it was I look forward to it so much. So I still watch their old videos. So Raising the Bars, if you have ever thought about coming back, I would be so excited. Oh, Shane Dawson, of course. Do you speak any languages and how well? Well, I speak English, obviously. I think pretty well, but you can debate me on it. And I took 2 years of Spanish in high school. And then I took a year of Spanish in college. Because I thought, oh, well, 3 years of, educational school Spanish, I will be fluent. Wrong. If you don't use it, it just never, actually sticks in your brain. Number 19, are you single or taken? Neither, I'm married. It's different. What is your idea of your dream date? Oh, well, I can tell you the best date my husband ever took me on. Hold on, I'm gonna do my eyebrows because I can't talk into my eyebrows. It requires too much focus. Hold on. Okay, I'm back. Okay, next question. Oh, yeah, I was gonna tell you guys about the best date my husband ever took me on. 1 year for our anniversary, Kyle drove me to Napa. We pull up and we get into a parking lot and I get out of the car and I look up at the sign for where we are, and we were at the Napa Valley Wine Train, which if you don't know what that is, Google it. It's incredible, real fancy, multi-course meal that's paired with wine. As we are driving, driving through the Napa Valley at sunset, and it was the most incredible, magical date I have ever been on in my entire life. I used to joke when we were planning our wedding that I was it's gonna have to beat the wine train, and that's a lot. So our wedding, of course, beat the wine train, but the wine train, I always say, is it was was magical. Okay, number 21, how long was your longest relationship? Well, it's the one I'm currently in. My longest relationship is the one with my husband. We have been together for almost 10 years. We met at a movie theater. Fun story, there was this like big company ice skating party, and I didn't think that I needed to request the night off because it was on a weekday and they didn't normally schedule high schoolers on weekdays. Unless you're 18, then they do. So I didn't even look at the schedule. I just like brought myself to the holiday party with my friends. And while I'm at the holiday party, some of the managers that are there go, Nicole, they're looking for you at work. And I'm like, what? No, like I don't work tonight. They were like, yeah, you do. So I found out while I was at the company holiday party that I was 2 hours late for my shift. Worked my shift, but I had never closed before and I was working in the concession stand. And working in the concession stand, closing in a movie theater, is a lot more challenging than you think. Like you have to clean a lot of like machinery. One of them being the popcorn popper, and that bad boy is dangerous to clean if you don't know what you're doing. My husband was working in the box office, and usually when you're done like with ticket sales in the box office, you get to go home. He agreed to stay and help me like close the concession stand. He like taught me how to clean the popcorn popper. The funny thing is, it wasn't like love at first sight. I thought Kyle was like 10 years older than me, and I was like, well, I have no business talking to him. The rest is kind of history. Except for the part where he had a girlfriend. This makes me look like a bad person. I'm not, I swear. It all worked out for everybody in the end. Maybe I'll do a story time about it because it's actually kind of funny. Okay, number 22. How would you describe your fashion sense? Comfortable? Number 23. What is your go-to hairstyle? I mean, I like to curl it, wear it straight, or wear it up in a bun. Those are the three things I do. Number 24. How many siblings do you have? I have one. His name is Michael. And he is almost 2 years older than me. Number 25, what is your go-to fast food order? My favorite fast food now is actually the Carl's Jr. Beyond Burger with no cheese and onion rings or fries, depending on my mood. Number 26, do you use PC or a Mac? I use a PC. Number 27, your most memorable vacation memory. My most memorable vacation memory, maybe my honeymoon was really wonderful, but like, I think if you're married and you've been on your honeymoon, you know it's the best vacation you've ever had. Number 28, what are your morning or evening routines? Well, if you want to see, comment down below and I'll film one for you. Number 29, do you have any bad habits? I like am a really like stressy type person. Like my knee-jerk reaction to anything is to stress about it. So I guess that's a bad habit because I think that that's a terrible like first reaction for things is like stress. That's the makeup look for the night. Like I said, I am not professional at doing makeup, but I do okay, you know? I'm not winning awards out here for it, but I'm also not looking like a hobo, so that's great. The last question that says, tell us one thing about you that we wouldn't know. Fun story, I was born without a joint in my right thumb. When I was born, my mom looked at the doctor and said, oh my God, she has a toe for her thumb. Not true. Initially they thought that I had a joint in my thumb and it just like needed to be like popped back in, that it just got like dislocated. Nope, when they did an x-ray, they found out that I just was born without a joint, only in my right thumb though. And it bends. And this one like couldn't bend it if I tried. So that's a fun fact. That's my cool fun fact. So that wraps it up for my get ready with me for date night with my husband / get to know me as I answer 30 questions about myself. I hope you enjoyed it and I will talk to you guys in the next video.